Hello everyone, it's Chris from Rekombu and I'm here with the Sony Xperia XZ1. So it's freshly launched flagship phone, just got announced a couple of days ago at IFA 2017, and Sony were lovely enough to give us this fully boxed, finished retail model. So we're going to give it a quick unboxing and check out the latest flagship. So of course it is basically a boosted version of last year's Xperia XZ with some of the best features also found on the Xperia XZ Premium, which came out earlier this year. As you can see, the box itself is supports very typical sort of Sony design. It's a nice plain exterior and all the rest of it, and then of course you've got the jazzy little swirls along the side. Very nice stuff. And you can get this bad boy in a few different colors. This looks like we've got the standard black model, so not particularly exciting, vibrant finish, unfortunately, but still looks very, very sleek. So we've just got a little sticker here showing you how to actually stick stuff into it, etc. Lovely. Let's just peel off this front protector as well, and there we have the Sony Xperia XZ1. So not a million miles different from the XZ. You'd probably struggle to make them apart if you would just stick them side by side, front facing on, but there are a fair few differences. It is actually now a full unibody metal frame, hopefully a bit more scratch resistant than the Xperia XZ, fingers crossed, because that did scuff up a bit of a storm. Some slight differences around the camera side. As you can see, this camera lens ever so slightly jutting. Not so much. It's 19 megapixel MotionEye, and of course you get the usual LED flash and everything, bit of NFC action there as well. See, there's a little bit of banding at the top here. It's actually got three aerials scattered around the body. I believe they say near the top, near the bottom, and one around the edge as well. So hopefully you should keep strong connectivity no matter how you grip the thing. Of course you get the edge mounted fingerprint sensor as well, just built into the side of the frame there. So that's it's really easy to find when you pick up the phone. It just naturally lies under your thumb or your finger, depending on obviously which hand you use to hold it. And a bit of volume action there as well. There's another one of the aerials. And along this side, of course, you have the little pull-out flap. There we go. And that's where just where you can shove in your SIM card and your micro SD memory card as well. And down below, a bit of Type-C USB action as well for charging. Well, of course, you get a headphone jack up top if you want to go wired instead of wireless. And as you can see, of course, it's the typical Sony loop design. It's nice and symmetrical, perfectly curved around the edges, which helps to make for a reasonably comfortable clutch. Great stuff. Right, so we're going to check out the rest of the box now as well, see what other exciting stuff we have in here. Well, bit of manual and cable action in this one, always good. So yeah, all your reading gubbins. And the thing's right down the other end. Come on, you just do it this way. It'll be the easiest, won't it? There we go. Hey, look at that. It's a Type-C USB cable. Bet you haven't seen one of those before. Excellent. And unfortunately, this is a European model, so it's a two-pin plug. Boo. But of course, if you order it in the UK, you will get the standard three-pin plug. Hooray. And that, unfortunately, is about as exciting as the box gets. There's not really a huge amount in there. But the important thing is that you get the phone, and that's the bit that we're all excited about. And now I've gone and put these stickers on there. Let's peel them up the paint. Excellent. Good job, me. Right, let's see if there's any juice in this bad boy. Yes, there we go. It's kicking into life. Excellent. We can get it all set up and check out the interface and stuff as well. One thing I didn't mention before is, of course, it's fully IP68 water and dust resistant, just like the Xperia XZ and the Xperia XZ Premiums. That's always good. You can take it in the bath, read a bit of your Facebooks, do whatever you like. Take it in the swimming pool, maybe not a public swimming pool. People might think that's a bit weird. You might get kicked out. Here we are into the interface. So just swipe up. Oh, it looks like it's already been set up actually. Okay, one of the Sony bods has already done that for me apparently. But it'll be a typical Sony setup process, we'd imagine. All the usual setting up the Wi-Fis and the rest, fun times. As you can see, of course, Sony's usual overlay as well on top of Android. Now this should be running Android Nougat at the moment. If you just dive into settings. It is actually running Android Oreo, which should be coming with it at launch, which is great. Fantastic news. There we go, Android 8.0.0. So we'll be having a good whiz around that in a bit as well. So the settings, of course, you've got loads and loads of stuff to dive into there. The display, it's a 5.2 inch Full HD IPS, so again, just like the Xperia XZ. And of course, you get all of the usual Sony bonus video modes and all the rest of it as well. So for instance, jump into color gamut and contrast, and you can boost it up to a nice bit of super vivid, which I do personally like. It just makes those images a bit more vibrant, a bit more lush. Let's just turn off that rotation because that's going to get really annoying really quickly. And of course, you've got video image enhancement as well to just basically sort of boost the clarity a little bit of your videos, which is always on by default. If you dive down a little bit more, obviously you can change the themes and all the rest of it, get it set up exactly how you like. Battery life. So battery, we've got a 2700 milliamp battery packed away inside with the usual QNovo tech to help increase the lifespan of the battery, which is always good. So it just prevents the overcharging, basically. You can obviously dive down and see exactly what apps have been using up the battery life and all the rest of it. And you've got the usual stamina mode and ultra stamina mode as well. If you're like on the final dregs of the battery life, you just want to grab a little bit more out of it. Storage, you get 64 gigs of storage. Let's see how much of that is actually free. So that's not too bad. So it's only used up 11 gigs with the OS and the other apps and all the rest of it. So you've still got plenty of space in there. By my mental maths, around 53. Yes, I did do A-level kiddies. And as you can see, it's just that's what's using it. Mostly, obviously, the system stuff for now. You've still got plenty of space. You can also free up space by clearing the cache and all the rest of it whenever you want, which is quite handy. And as mentioned before, there's micro SD memory card support as well. So you can chuck in a card up to 256 gigs in size. Back in the settings, obviously, you can set up the old fingerprint. So let's do a bit of that. Da, 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 da. There we go, done. How quick and easy was that? So you just slightly push the surface and it immediately unlocks the phone. Look at how quick and responsive that is. That is good. That's probably the quickest we've ever seen on the Sony phone, actually. Normally there's a little bit of a, you know, it's not quite as swift as like the HTC U11 and stuff like that, but that is actually really, really quick indeed. You do have to actually push the button in ever so slightly. If you just tap your thumb, it doesn't unlock, unlike some phones. But it's just a tiny little push and in you're in. There you go, lovely stuff. Speaking of lovely stuff, it's Snapdragon 835 processor that's running the show. And as you can see, it's pleasingly nippy. You know, we've had a good hands-on play with it and didn't notice a single stutter or issue as you would expect. It's very power efficient as well, so we're hoping that 2700 milliamp battery really does give us a decent bit of battery life. You know, hopefully at least a full day out of a single charge, preferably more. But yeah, no, I mean, this is nippy as anything, absolutely no problem. Your apps just load up instantly. Look at that, gorgeous stuff. And it's backed by 4 gigs of RAM, so that should help to keep everything moving smoothly. Of course, Android does have some other bonus Sony features thrown in as well. So for instance, you've got a bit of, hopefully, assistant. Yeah, here we go. So the Sony Assistant, which is good if you're a bit of a smartphone newbie, you don't really know much about Android, or it's your first Sony phone, you want to learn a little bit more about some of the Sony stuff that's built in there. But as you can see, you can set up various modes, so you can knock off Wi-Fi automatically, all that kind of stuff. You've got your battery care as well in there, so it's in a little shortcut, smart cleaner, again, to clean up your memory and your storage and all the rest of it. And yeah, just tells you a little bit about your phone, exactly what you want to do with it. There we go, all the main features highlighted with little animations and stuff, which is always good. You also, of course, if we dive into the apps, you get Sony's own music, album, video apps, and you should hopefully have a bit of PlayStation Remote Play as well. Can't actually see it in there, but they did tell me that it will definitely support PlayStation Remote Play. So either I'm being incredibly blind or it's just not on this phone for some reason. But yeah, we should be able to get a bit of that on the go. If you have a PS4, you can just stream the game directly to this handset and then yeah, get your gaming on the go while you're on the toilet, in bed, doing whatever you need to do. So that's always good. And yeah, complementing that gorgeous 5.2-inch vibrant display, there's also the new S4 speakers above and below the screen. Apparently these are 50% more powerful. They can force out more air than the Xperia XZ. So we can give that a quick test out now. Okay, here we go. Turn down for what is our generic go-to audio test sample, by the way, just in case you're wondering. Let's boost it all the way up. Wow. Okay, so definitely a pleasing top volume. That's just as powerful as like the HTC U11 with its boom speaker setup. And the music quality actually sounds pretty good, considering considering it's a smartphone speaker. That's actually not bad at all. So there you go, that's the S4 speakers, positioned above and below. As I said before, so you do get that nice stereo speaker setup. And yeah, always better than when they're mounted on the edges, because always your palms end up pressing them and it kind of muffles the music and everything. So there you go. I think that's about everything that I need to talk to you about in terms of the software and everything. I guess in terms of the audio stuff as well, if we dive into that section of the settings, wherever that may be, sound. Of course, Sony's put its usual audio techno wizardry, I guess you would call it, on there. So you can play high-res audio tracks whenever you want. You've got DSEHX, which basically boosts the quality of those lower quality compressed tracks, just give them a bit more oomph, make them sound a bit better. It likes a Clear Audio Plus and stuff as well, so you can just play around with the sound effects yourself, mess around with the equalizer, all that kind of stuff. So you got plenty of stuff in there. So audio fans are definitely well catered for indeed. And of course, Sony has just launched a new range of here, I believe they want you to pronounce it as, so don't put a full stop in it maybe. Here headphones, which also complement the colors of the Xperia XZ1s. You can get one to match if you so desire, always good. And then of course there's the camera tech. So it's the new MotionEye 19 megapixel rear camera. And this is a bit of a beast. We had a play around at the IFA 2017 pre-brief. So go check that out if you want like a full in-depth analysis of all the new features and all the rest of it. But all you need to know is, once again, superior auto mode is absolutely excellent. You've got full person tracking, object tracking, and all the rest of it. It's got the usual predictive motion stuff, so it keeps your subject nice and crisp. You can even do burst mode now using that, using the predictive motion stuff, which is great. So you just tap on your subject, hold down the shutter button, and it rattles off up to 10 shots a second, up to 100 shots in total. And your autofocus works throughout as well, so it keeps them nice and sharp, which is great. Haven't seen that on a phone before, as far as I can remember. So that's definitely a very good feature to have, especially since Sony ditched that burst mode for a while. And of course, you've got the full manual settings if you want to fiddle around with stuff yourself, if you're a bit more of a confident photographer. Because you get video mode, one of the big additions from the XZ Premium is that super slow motion mode, which of course allows you to shoot up to 960 frames per second. Some really, really incredible results. You've got to be really, really swift on the key though, because it only shoots for about a second. And then there's a bit of a cool down period, but that's a great, great mode. You got some really good action shots with it. And then they slimmed down the bonus mode section. Just got like the likes of creative effects and a panorama. You can, of course, now shoot 4K video direct in the video section, which is good. You don't have to go to the special bonus modes anymore. So there you go, a bit of 4K action. Very nice. And then, yeah, all the usual object tracking. Steady shot, of course, you only get standard steady shot in 4K resolution, but if you bump that down to 30 frames per second full HD, you can then bump that up to intelligent active. And Sony's stabilization is just absolutely fantastic. It really does the job. Even on 4K, the standard stuff, it does really well, the digital stabilization. So great stuff. And around the front, you've got a 13 megapixel front facing camera as well. So certainly got strong photography chops. As I say, go check out our full camera preview if you want us to know more. The camera review will be going up imminently as well, so we'll be going out and giving this a thorough testing over the weekend, and hopefully get some really nice shots and the rest of it to share with you guys later. So that in a nutshell is the Sony Xperia XZ1 with a bit of Android Oreo. If you've got any questions, comments, or anything, let us know. We'll be doing a full review, camera review, tips and tricks, and all the rest of it as well. So definitely stay tuned for all of that. And thanks for watching, you lovely people. Love you, bye.